One all.
Unbelievable stuff from Pouille. Just able to keep bringing just enough to keep this match close.
So the mini breaks exchange to begin. In the first fifth set tiebreak, the 2016 US Open here in Arthur Ashe Stadium. The first five set match over the course of these opening days. Just six errors in this set for Rafa, starting to agitate Uncle Tony. Not much he can do from his position, and Rafa knows it. The server has not held for a point yet in these opening three.
Unbelievable. Nadal, maybe you're right. Maybe he is getting tender because he's certainly backing off. He's not the one that's being the aggressor right now. Pouille is taking his chances, hitting the backhand big, seeing the opening, and going for it.
Yeah, Rafa's not one to overlook opponents, but he has to have felt like, I should have shaken this guy already. Maybe Pouille actually really has some gas left in the tank. That the two previous five-set matches, just to get to this point, did nothing to fatigue him. Pouille holds for 4-1. And the crowd tries to rally Nadal's spirit.
Hi, please. Thank you.
So the swap ends, 6 points on the board. Pouille with the slight edge and the ability to just give himself a moment of pause. Outside, they are desperate to get back inside Arthur Ashe Stadium, these ticket holders, but they're going to be denied for a while. There's still tennis to be played now, 19 minutes after 7 p.m. You see to the east gate to the left and the south gate at the top of the screen outside Arthur Ashe Stadium. Everyone fixated on the screens and the scoreboards around the grounds here at the USTA Billie Jean King National Tennis Center. You can't help but feel that some are still sort of scratching their heads going, I'm not sure I recognize Pouille. They'll be talking about him a lot following this match. He's got the five seed and two-time champion in a spot of bother, to say the least. Into the fifth hour as Pouille assumes the role of server, leading 4-3. Additional challenge afforded both in the tiebreak scenario, each with three. Nadal wasted little time in lifting his hand to issue the challenge, and here's the chase review. Call was out.
Five, three, Pouille. Nadal has two challenges remaining.
They thought it was over. Pouille down a break in the deciding set. How could he possibly hang on in his third consecutive five-set match? 4 hours and 2 minutes after he began this contest with a four-seed Nadal, he finds himself with a shot at his second straight quarterfinal at a major. And an upset of the two-time champion here.
Six, five.
Knowledge and experience and dealing with such pressurized situations. Nadal has indeed been here numerous times. A third match point for the Frenchman, this time on his racket. Rafa and Luka continue on, and oh my, did this crowd help Nadal. I'll tell you what, Taylor, that first serve almost landed in the practice courts outside of the stadium. I mean, it hit the baseline for all intents and purposes, and you can almost assuredly attribute that to the fact the crowd just gave a real last second gasp charge for Nadal. And
he was looking for a cheap point. Absolutely, with that forehand and a couple points before, way behind the baseline, trying to wail away on a forehand. He is not wanting to play points right now.
Three match points saved. Pouille's not done at the line. More chance to find his way to match point.
Please.
Well, it'll only be a moment, but you saw how shocked even Rafa was. And Pouille has been afforded another lifeline. That one was jarring for Nadal.
Well, if you ask Nadal what type of ball he wants at six all in the fifth set breaker, I would like a short, soft, midcourt ball on my forehand side.
It'll require a quick recovery as the Frenchman has match point number four. Vive la France inside Arthur Ashe Stadium. Luca Pouille has done the unthinkable in taking out his first ever top five opponent, and it is two-time U.S. Open champion Rafael Nadal that is his victim. What a magnificent performance from this 22-year-old.